welcome back to my kitchen. Today I shall share a recipe that's kids special and it is very popular among kids. It is pizza, and I'm sure you all would have had pizza, or you would have tried it at home or bought it from shops. I don't know, you would have tried varieties of it, because if you have children around, that is what happens everywhere. So today let us see a wheat pizza. It's not maida. Wheat Indian style pizza, not Western style. So let's go to the kitchen to see how to prepare a wheat Indian style paneer pizza. Come on, friends. So for today's recipe, I have not spread the complete ingredients. I'll be telling you as and when I do it, and I would give you instructions. So please be careful and listen to me. So this is wet damp cloth and duff. I have closed it with wet damp cloth and covered it. You can see it's very soft out here. And it's slightly become fluffy. It wouldn't double because this is no yeast pizza. I have not used yeast. Instead, all you have to do is take 2 cups of wheat flour, ground it in the mill, or packet wheat flour. Choice is yours. Take 2 cups of wheat flour. To it, add salt to taste, 2 tablespoons of sugar, baking soda, baking powder, 1 tablespoon each, and then little bit of curd, 2 tablespoons of curd, and then add water, and then knead it into a soft dough. You can see how soft it is. I can feel it in the hand. And then after you do that, just apply a little bit of oil on top. Close it with a damp cloth. That's all you have to do. And after you do that, it has to rest for about 1 hour. 1 hour or 1.5 hour. So that it would become even more softer. And it might rise up a little. Yeah. Since it is paneer pizza, Indian style, we have taken 1 cup smallly chopped paneer cubes. Yeah, and then 1.5 or medium sized, 2 sized onions chopped into 1-inch pieces, just to spread it on the pizza. And then 2 medium sized capsicum chopped into 1.5 inch of pieces each, just to spread it on the pizza. Now this is for pizza sauce. That also should be homemade, not store bought. So just take 2 to 3 medium sized tomatoes and chop it into bigger size pieces, because anyways you're going to cook it, so never mind if it is like this. And again, 2 to 3 medium sized onions, chop them also into bigger pieces like this. So I have taken an iron kadai. You can take any non-stick or anything you want. Today I have taken an iron kadai. Now to it, I am adding 2 tablespoons of oil, cooking oil. You can use any oil, you can use olive oil also. I leave that to you. Then after the oil is hot, add in the onions. You can add tomatoes together. You don't have to wait till the onions are cooked. So add both together. To it, I'm adding red chilies. I have not spread these ingredients, as I said. So please note it down. I'm adding 3 Kashmiri red chilies for color. You can choose either green chilies or red chilies. Choice is yours. But today I have taken red chilies, and the spice level I leave it to you. So you can see the tomatoes and onions are getting cooked. It has to get cooked well. That means the tomatoes are supposed to get mashed. So we have to give that time. Meanwhile, in another kadai, I have taken to it. Let's add 4 tablespoons of oil. So after the oil is warm, add in the powders first. Just be careful. Please note this. I'm adding 1 tablespoon of chili powder and 2.5 tablespoon of garam masala, and then 1.5 tablespoon of coriander powder. And to it, add salt. That is just required for paneer. That's it. Please remember, add salt to this kadai. That is needed only for paneer. Now these powders are roasted. To it I'm adding paneer. After you have sauteed for 1 minute, that's enough. Just to saute and that's enough. At that time you can add just 2 teaspoons of fresh cream. After the cream is added, just give it a proper mix. That's it. Don't leave it for a longer time. After you saute paneer, sauteing is enough. Saute paneer, then add fresh cream and you give it a proper mix, and that's it. Switch off the gas. Then meanwhile, this is completely cooked. You can see the tomatoes and onions are cooked so well. Everything has turned mushy. Tomatoes have turned mushy. That's it. So after it cooled down a little bit, I have ground this into a smooth paste. So in the same kadai, I'm adding 2 tablespoons of butter. Then to it, I'm adding in the ground tomato onion paste. So you can see this mixture has become glossy after you added butter. So after you add the mixture to it, you have to add a little bit of coriander powder. So to this I'm adding 1 tablespoon of coriander powder, salt to taste, salt only for this tomato and onion, remember. So this is the main thing you have to remember when preparing this, because you're doing it separately, so you have to add salt separately, and only to that particular item you need to add salt. And after you add salt, if you want chili powder, if you want it very spicy, add little bit of chili powder to this also. Today I have not added that. I leave that spice levels to you. And to this again add a little bit of cream, say 2 to 3 tablespoons of cream. This is just to make the pizza rich enough to eat. So you can see the butter has, you know, started coming out like oil. It's become creamy, so it's the right stage. You can switch it off. This thing has to be little thick. See, you must be able to spread it on the pizza base. So I have taken the dough and cut them into 6 equal parts. Okay. Now this chutney, call it chutney or pizza base, whatever it is, it is ready. Now I'll show in 2 things, that is on tawa and OTG, microwave oven. I'm showing it in both, so just watch it out. So preheat the oven for about 10 minutes at 200 degree temperature, and in the tray spread little butter or oil. I leave that to you. I have spread butter and dust it with semolina, rava or maida or any flour, even corn flour will do. So if you are using maida, you can, you know, use your hands and fluff the, you know, can make it pliable. But since it is wheat, it will take a lot of time, so you can use your rolling pin and just roll it into thin or thick crust. That is your choice. So I have placed it on the tray, the cooking tray of the oven. To it I'm adding a little bit of butter. After you spread the butter, add the spread or the sauce and spread that too. So after you spread the sauce, spread the vegetables. This I leave it to you, this choice I leave it to you. Today I have made it very simple. You know, you can use mushrooms, corn, make it farm fresh. You can use tomatoes, jalapeno, oregano, you can use anything you want, but today I have made it very simple. To place all the vegetables, grate a little bit of cheese to it. You can grate anything, mozzarella cheese or cheddar cheese, the choice is yours, so normal cheese. So all set, cheese, everything is ready. I'm going to cook this for 10 minutes, 10 to 15 minutes. I'm going to bake it in the oven. So I'm placing it inside the oven, closing it. It's set at 200 degree temperature, bake mode. then keeping it for 10 minutes. So I have taken another ball and rolled it with a pin. I'm going to show how to prepare this on tawa. So after you do that, poke it with fork thoroughly. This is just to make cooking faster and easier, because it's going to be a very thick one, so it might take time. So just to make it easier and the flavors to enter it completely, just poke it with a fork. Now on an iron tawa, after it is hot enough, I have added little bit of butter. So after all the vegetables and sauce, everything is done on the wheat flour, on the base, I have transferred it to the iron kadai. I'm sorry, iron skillet. All you have to do is close it with a lid, cook it for about 6 minutes. After about 10 minutes time, it is baked. It might take 10 to 15 minutes, so keep checking in between. It depends on the oven and it depends on the quality of the wheat and all that. So make sure you keep checking it in between. So this is done. I have cut one piece for your display. See, it is so soft, thin crust. And this is tawa pizza, and this is also soft and thin, and this is also just for your display. Serve it with any sauce. So you saw how to prepare the Indian style paneer pizza in my kitchen. So do try it at your home and let me know, give me feedback. Subscribe my channel, keep supporting me as usual. Click the notification button for further notifications from my channel. Keep supporting me. Thank you so much. Bye bye for now.